Face the Nation moderator and CBS News political director John Dickerson is in Washington. John, good morning.
Good morning, Charlie.
So what did you think was the most important thing to come out of this debate?
Well, I think the biggest thing was at the bottom of all these back and forths on all these issues was a debate versus vision, big goals, steering towards one big bright star, and incrementalism. That's what Bernie Sanders would call it, or Hillary Clinton would say, just effective progress, execution on goals. And this is happening on the Republican side, too. It's really, what do you expect? What can actually happen in government? And who do you want there? Somebody who can work the system or somebody who sets big goals and is really going to change and revolutionize things?
There was a lot of talk this morning, John, about it was combative, contentious, nasty, very bad tone. But there is a lot at stake here. Shouldn't it be contentious and combative? It never seemed personal last night to me. Did it to you?
Yeah, not since the Sharks and the Jets in New York. It was, you know, I think it got a little snippy. Bernie Sanders was a little overly sarcastic there. They can take it in New York. They're not going to blanch at that. I think the fact that it mostly kept coming back to that central question, which is Bernie Sanders just selling a lot of sort of fantasy dreams? And is Hillary Clinton too pinned in by her incrementalism and her relationship with Wall Street? Those are central questions of this debate. And so I agree with you. It didn't really get personal in a way that certainly we've seen on the Republican side.
Former Obama speechwriter Jon Favreau tweeted, quote, "Whoever told Bernie to go relentlessly angry and negative gave him very, very bad advice. He's come this far because of his inspiration." What about that, John? And did Bernie Sanders hurt himself when he was unable to answer the question by Dana Bash about how donations from Wall Street to Hillary Clinton, that she was asked, name one piece of policy that she's been influenced because of that? And he couldn't answer.
That was a whiff on his part, the fact that he didn't have a specific. However, people don't find it crazy that somebody would make the case that he's making, which is when you get a lot of money from an industry that you'll be less tough on them. So it would have been nice for his campaign if he'd had a specific, but I think in general, his point probably still stands. To the criticism about his tone, you know, what Bernie Sanders needs, based on all the Democrats I've talked to, is a game-changing moment because of where the delegate numbers are. He doesn't need to just win, he needs to win big. And that, without changing that tone, that might be hard to do. Does well with his group, but may not be able to expand it to the group he needs to get to win by the margins he needs.
Thank you so much, John.